Welcome back to the Budget Gamer channel, where you can find reviews on the latest or at least the cheapest indie games out there. Normally I like to start off the reviews by telling you a bit about how I feel about the game, but in all honesty for this one, I'm not quite sure. I know that it's a good game with a lot of entertainment value, but as far as White Knight's concerned, I just don't know how I feel about it. You start off the game by hitting a pedestrian as you drive home from a bar in a sort of Great Depression Prohibition era setting. And this setting is phenomenally complemented by the game's art style and by its musical soundtrack, as well as allows you to establish yourself as this film noir style, kind of grungy detective. And the damsel in distress element of the game, as well as the really gritty voiceovers, just really drive home the whole theme. And more or less the initial motivation in the game is merely the fact that you were involved in an accident and now are injured and need to find help. The person that you struck is nowhere to be found, but lo and behold, there is a dark, dingy, abandoned manor that, even though it has a graveyard sitting right out front, is most likely full of amazing people and a working phone. And while this is a bit of a Scooby-Doo-ish kind of trope, it works really well and it transitions very quickly into the main story. Very quickly as the player, you realize that you have just been trapped in some horrible ghost-ridden manor, and now instead of trying to find help, you're trying to find your way out. However, despite the abject darkness and definite spookiness, there's something going on behind the scenes that your detective skills are kind of also wanting you to investigate. However, unlike most of the typical story game puzzlers out there, and where I actually give this one a bit of street cred, is in the fact that it's not as simple as just walking around the manor and solving puzzles. One of the main focal elements of the game is the use of matches to light your way through the darkness. The previous owners of the rundown manor realized that there were a lot of issues with the electrical, so they left matchbooks and matches all around for you to be able to find. However, they only last for about a minute if you're walking around, and 30 seconds if you're running, but you can only carry 12 at a time. This fact, combined with the somewhat 30s-era film noir shooting style and cinematography, really will cause you to spend a lot of time trying to find out your bearings. So there will be several times where you find yourself locked in a room with only 2 or 3 matches and the entire area to explore. And this brings us to the next point that obviously Haunted kind of implies: you're not alone here. This manor is full of wraiths that don't really care for your presence, and if they see your little matchlight, they're gonna chase you down. However, you are able to run from them, and if you get far enough away from their spawn point, they kind of leave you alone. And the pièce de résistance is electric light. A lot of the puzzles will involve you figuring out how to connect throw breakers or plug in lights in order to use to blaze your way through these spooks. And as we've learned from every ghost story in our childhood, more light is better. However, there is one element that I haven't actually talked about yet, and that is the whole guiding principle of film noir detective mystery. And that, as you've probably guessed, is murder. And yes, true to the film tropes, there has been a murder, so as you're trying to avoid ghouls and find your way out of this mansion, you're also going to be trying to figure out a mystery. And clues, letters, newspaper clippings, notes, and pictures scattered all around the mansion are going to aid you piece by piece in putting together exactly what happened and exactly whose demonic house you're in. But as cool as this 6-hour haunted mystery seems to be, there are a few negative points that you really need to be aware of before you start playing the game. First and foremost is going to be the load times. Obviously, this is a larger game, so I would have expected a long initial load time, but that 30 to 40 second load time is going to happen pretty much in between every room or every floor that you go to. But that being said, massive chunks of the game are generally played in singular areas, so the break between rooms really doesn't actually occur that often. And the second major consideration is actually one of the cool points of the game, but the other side of the coin. The use of black and white and light and dark in this game, combined with its amazing cinematography, actually is a bit disorienting. The camera angles in the game are fixed, so even if you're walking through a narrow straight hallway, the fixed camera points can change between 2 and 3 times. And if you are, say, trying to run away from a ghost that's trying to kill you, that can really throw you off your track. But other than that, there's really not much wrong with the game. It is a gritty detective mystery with some cool puzzle elements. And a story that will kind of knock your socks off, maybe even in a way that you don't expect. And as the whole thrill of this game is the story, I can't really tell you what that is, but when you do experience it for yourself, you might understand why I started the video the way I did. I really enjoyed playing the game, and I think it's a great game, but I just don't know how I feel about it. But if you have any questions about that, feel free to direct message me or send me an email. We can talk about it all day long. Well, anyway, that about wraps up the review of White Knight on the Switch eShop. So if you enjoyed the review or found it helpful, feel free to throw me a like or a comment to show your support. And don't forget to click that little bell icon when you subscribe to stay updated with the latest content. New and unique indies are coming out nearly every day, and they're always going on sale, so there's always going to be something new to find right here. But anyway, this has been Budget Gamer, so as always, thanks for watching.